Hello, everyone, and welcome to The Walking Dead, A New Frontier. This is Season 3 of The Walking Dead. We finally get to reunite with Clementine, and we meet a new character, Javier. And this right here, which you see in front of you, is the very prolific story builder, in which there's 42 different ways in which your Clementine could end up. You can do a new story, which means you'll pick choices from Seasons 1, Seasons 2, maybe even choices from The 400 Days, maybe Michonne, I don't know. I've played everything up until this point. I don't have my Season 1 save because it was on my PS3. I don't know if my Season 2 save even exists, but what I'll try to do is I will try to continue the story here and see what we can all pick. So now I have to recreate it here, huh? Okay, so yeah, now this is the part where I don't have all of my story bits because I played Season 1 on my PS3. I didn't have it on my PC at the time. So, let's see. Let's go down memory lane here and try to rebuild the Clementine. This is like a Build-A-Bear Clementine. I'm so excited for this, by the way. This has been one of my most anticipated games since Season 2 ended. I'm so pumped for this. So let's see here. In The Walking Dead Season 1, Clementine met Lee after she lost her family and home. He protected her and taught her the importance of justice, survival, self-reliance, and community. And each one of these has a caption. The only hope people have is to help each other. Without a code, how can you trust anyone? Even a child should be able to defend herself from danger and self-reliance. In the end, you can only count on yourself. Oh, God. Now, I feel like Lee... Oh, man. I'm gonna go community. Oh, God! Not this again! By the way, if you haven't played The Walking Dead Season 1 or Season 2 or any of that, you better go back and play it right now, because there's gonna be spoilers galore. Clem and Lee traveled to Savannah, where Lee sacrificed himself to save her. As he lay dying, Lee begged Clem to shoot him or to leave him to turn. This is what I did. To shoot him one. I hated this. After Lee's death, Clem found more survivors. People who helped her, such as Kenny, Luke, and Jane. Kenny never gave up. His endless determination helped keep Clementine alive. Luke always had a smile for Clementine. And Jane. Now, in my Season 2, I shot Kenny. I hate it. I shot Kenny. And I let Jane come with me. I didn't kill Jane either. But Kenny's the one who was with us, right? Clementine remembered the joy she felt when she was reunited with Kenny. He showed her that survival depended on determination, honesty, and family, huh? Family was definitely a Kenny thing, right? He was a family man. That's what Kenny's all about. This total... None of those other than family would make sense. Thanks to her companions, Clem's journey ultimately led her to Wellington, Hose Hardware, to travel alone. What do I do, guys? Do I pick the Kenny route? Or do I go with what I did when I actually played Season 2? What do I do, guys? I don't know. I'm gonna go with the one that I did. I kind of want to see the Kenny one, though, because, like, Kenny! He's, like, one of the only characters from the first season outside of Clementine. Let's see here. I'll choose House Hardware. As they settled into House, Clem and Jane were approached by a starving family, and we decided to let them in or turn them away. Oh boy, this is a big decision. I let them in, I'm pretty sure. Clem learned the hard way that survival depended on resources or people. So, I remember this. We chose people, because we didn't take the bag, I don't think. Oh, I can't remember. It never got any easier. Okay, so this is Rebecca. If you don't remember Rebecca, she's the one who birthed Alvin Jr., which is the child that Clementine has, and Alvin Jr. The father of Alvin Jr. is either Alvin or Carver. We don't know. It never got any easier. Clem remembers how she stopped AJ's dead mother from biting him during an ambush by drawing her gun and risked it. Oh God, what did I do? Snap decisions are often a bad idea, especially during an intense standoff. There's no time to do anything else when a baby's life is at stake. I can't remember! Oh God! Did I shoot? Never give up. Okay. In Season 2, Clementine showed loyalty to her friends and family, even in the most desperate situations. When Kenny and Jade's fighting put everyone at risk, Clementine reluctantly shot Kenny to save Jane's life. Clem, AJ, and Jane returned to House, where they took a family in, looking for shelter. And now, there's 42 different ways this could go. Apparently. So, Let's start the story. Man, I feel like I'm not gonna be able to see Kenny because of this, but you know, maybe Kenny's gone anyway. Let's start the story and see what happens. Maybe we'll see Jane. Maybe we'll see Clementine. Is that Jesus? I'm pretty sure Jesus is in this. Okay, so it looks like there's 5 episodes. And I do know that we get the first 2 episodes right away, which is pretty exciting. Ties That Bind, Part 1. So this will be Ties That Bind, Part 2. Sure enough, this is Above the Law. Thicker Than Water. And From the Gallows. I'm pretty sure one of you guys told me that Negan may show up in this. Is that true? I don't know, but that'd be kind of cool. When Javier and his family accidentally cross paths with a rival group, a simple misunderstanding quickly spirals out of control. We've been waiting years for this, man. Let's get into it. I'm so excited. This game series adapts to the choices you make. The story is tailored to how you play. This is it, guys. The moment we've been waiting for years. Telltale knows that this is their big thing. So they want it to be great. We want it to be great. It's going to be great. I fully, fully believe in Telltale.
Hey.
Hey.
It's time. Get over here.
All right. I'll start packing up.
Now, Javi, you need to hurry. Look, I'm not giving you shit, okay? You weren't here when Dad was sick, okay? I get it, but you need to fucking be here when he goes.
I know. All right, I'm on my way.
So Javier is one of the main characters in The Walking Dead Season 3. It's going to be Javier and Clementine. I don't know who we're going to play as, honestly. I think we're going to play as both of them. Like, I'm not entirely sure this is all going to be about
David.
Clementine.
David, hey.
So
hey,
some-
David. I had to leave my car. It's traffic's just backed up for miles.
What?
He's dead.
So this must be before.
No. I tried.
You're a piece of shit. You know that? One time. Just the one goddamn time that you needed to be here. And Javi is nowhere to be fucking found!
What? Excuse me? So this
Everyone's
must-
Everyone's here. They've been here for days, and where the fuck were you? We're there, all around him. People who love him all around him. And he's scared. I'm seeing the panic in his eyes, and he's searching the room. ¿Dónde está Javier? ¿Dónde está mi hijo? I'm there, right beside him, holding his hand. Like a good son. And he doesn't even see me. He doesn't even see me because he's looking for you.
You don't think there's a million places we'd rather be?
You don't think we all had to make sacrifices?
I'm sorry, okay? David, Jesus,
Sorry isn't bringing him back. You selfish fuck.
Yeah.
Uncle Javi? Why are you fighting?
Because your uncle's a dick.
I can hear you from inside.
Your dad's a dick.
What's going
on?
It's
nothing. It's nothing.
We were just, talking, Gabriel.
Right. Your uncle and I are just having a little chat.
Your dad's a dick, Gabe.
Go inside, mijo. We'll be in a minute. Go on. It's okay. Inside.
Or is Gabe the kid? Either way, this must be before everything, right? Because there's still people and traffic and no one's dead. Take his hand, refuse his hand. Fine, I'll take his hand.
I should call someone. Pick up the body.
Oh, we're buds now?
I love you, little brother. You know that, right?
Fuck
everything going on.
Well, you got a pretty funny way of showing it.
Just punched.
You think I was jealous of you?
No, I don't think anything.
Well, I was. For a long time. You've lost more than I'll ever have. But maybe something good can come out of all this. Because we need you here. It's time to grow up. You can't run from this. Not anymore.
I know you're right.
I know. You're right. I won't even argue.
I'll be around more, honestly. You can count on it,
huh? I want to believe that. I do.
Javi.
Kate.
Hi.
I'm so sorry, Javi. I'm so sorry.
Who are you?
Thank you.
Let's go inside. Your mom needs you.
The character models look really nice.
What happened?
That guy happened.
Come on.
Yeah, I wonder what Javier does. Interesting. Because his family kind of seems like they're not, you know, too wealthy here. It's based on the look of everything. And he doesn't, maybe the brother's upset that he's not helping out? I don't know. But yeah, they don't even know that they turn yet, do they? Oh boy.
Mama.
Where were you?
Another one.
I tried. I'm so sorry.
He's gone, mijo. He's gone.
He's in a better place, Mama.
This is about to be a really messed up funeral, let me tell you.
No puedo conectarme. Dicen que no hay servicio.
The cop car sirens must be normal because they ain't mentioning it. And they've been nonstop.
You thirsty, baby? You want some juice?
Grandpa's cup was empty.
Oh god. This is from the trailer. Oh no.
You don't have to fill his cup up anymore, baby. Grandpa is sleeping.
No, Yaya. Pipo's awake.
Oh, God, that's from the trailer. It's going to be so creepy. The Walking Dead, A New Frontier. Oh, God.
Peekaboo.
It's like, what's this kid on about? Oh, God. They're all like, what the hell? Yeah, they don't know. This must be before, like, everything started going down. This is when it first started. So, like, Lee's alive right now, technically.
Rafa, ¿cómo es esto posible?
Oh, God! Oh, no!
Papa!
Papa, stop!
God, how can you not be hyped
papa,
right now?
Papa, cálmate. Soy yo, David. Estás en tu casa,
estás
cálmate.
¿Qué haciendo?
Él está loco. Él atacó a Héctor.
Solamente está confundido.
Mamá.
Get away from him. He's gonna bite that. Oh, no. Oh god, they don't know.
Oh my god! Oh my god!
How'd you get her face?
It's okay.
He was held down!
Mom, you're gonna be okay. You'll be okay, Mom.
Help him! Help him!
David! I'm sorry, Papa.
We need to go. We need to get her to the hospital.
Let me look at it. Let me look at it. Gabriel, where's your sister?
I don't know.
Keys! Where the fuck are the keys?
Take Dad's car. Keys are on the dash.
Mama,
get the kids. Meet at the hospital. Don't take the highway. It's blocked.
That's why he couldn't get here. Okay, that makes sense. He couldn't get there because everything's going down right now.
We'll bring the van around.
And
where's
the roads Mari? Were blocked.
I don't know.
Mija.
Mariana!
¿Dónde estás?
Mariana, we have to go. Yaya's hurt. Come on, honey. We have to go.
No, no, no!
I'm so excited.
No!
It's okay.
No!
County General Hospital. I know the way.
Man, no one's wearing a seatbelt. Oh no. Did he get him? He did. He bit him. Uh-oh. Oh no. I mean, so what? For a little bit, right? You got time. I don't know how much time you got, but you got time, right? Man. I'm trying to think of like how long they last in the comics when they get bit. People don't really get bit and stay alive in the comics anymore. Like, they just get downed right away. Like, that was way at the beginning of the comics where they were still letting people live. Whoa! Whoa! Present day. Okay. So, yeah. Things have changed. But Javier's still alive.
Tell me when it reaches the campfire.
Oh, so are you. Nice facial hair, man. Maybe we should go. I've never seen so many. Maybe we should go.
I think we should probably get going.
We will. I just need to know how fast they're moving.
What? Damn it. I left my water bottle. Her just got there.
Just under 4 hours. Come on. We should keep moving while the kids are asleep.
Yeah.
They still got this thing? What? They still got the turdmobile after all this time. It's been years. I don't even know how old Clementine is right now. It's been like at least 3 or 4 years since it all went down. At least three.
It looks like the herd is speeding up a little.
Probably more.
I thought it was drifting southwest, but I'm not sure anymore. Every time I think we should just bed down somewhere and wait for it to pass, I can't shake the thought of us getting caught in the middle of it. It just keeps coming. It's slow, but that almost makes it worse. Makes it feel like we're in control.
We should keep moving. It worked for us so far. As long as we stay supplied, we're fine.
Yeah, maybe you're right.
The van isn't so bad.
We'll figure it out.
We always do.
I'm so nervous about all the choices we make, too.
I'm gonna sneak a smoke.
I can't believe you found weed.
Are you kidding?
Just gonna get high.
People were probably growing this before they realized they needed food.
No, don't get high right now. You want me to roll it? Don't wake the kids. Should we be smoking now?
You really think we should be smoking now?
Relax. Mariana's got headphones on and Gabe is drooling. I think we're in the clear.
The zombies! The zombies! Oh, God.
You want some?
No!
No. No, thanks.
I'm driving!
One of us should be sober.
Right?
Don't judge me.
I am judging so hard right now, you dummy. There's zombies.
Oh, when I found out David had kids, I told him I am not changing who I am around them. And when he proposed, I reminded him that I'm not exactly stepmother material. Case in point.
Jesus Christ.
He was reassuring, but you know, I could tell he was worried about it. I knew he'd try to get me to change. Or at least he'd hope that being around the kids more would change me, you know?
You miss him?
I suppose it did.
Do you miss him?
I think about that a lot. Honestly, I'm not sure.
Oh!
I used to talk shit about all those mothers who'd go on about raising their kids being the hardest thing in the world. Gabe's making me start to think they had a point.
She is choking
His
that down.
His mood swings are just... I don't know. Some days I just want to leave him by the side of the road.
I'm having so much trouble with that
choking.
Freaking smoke.
Jesus. Obviously.
Look, I didn't sign up for this either. Sometimes life decides for you. That sounded deep, didn't it?
No, it didn't.
You're high. Everything sounds deep.
Look, I love these kids, but I could do without Gabe reminding me I'm not his mother whenever he's pissed.
He's a teenager. Puberty, hormones. The second you start getting boners, the whole world starts to get dark.
What are you talking about? It sounds delightful compared to dealing with bloody underwear. Christ.
Blade.
Look at his face!
I realize that was an awkward transition. Sorry about that.
What's that smell?
Skunky weed. We had a skunk, right?
Hey, Mariana, I think we must have hit a skunk or something back there.
That's what weed smells like.
I already know you guys do drugs.
Oh, damn.
That's a pretty severe way of phrasing it, Mariana. Don't tell Gabe.
He's the one who told me.
Oh my god. You're even smoking in the car now?
All right. Everyone roll the windows down before you all get contact high. We're about to make a supply stop.
So, yeah, Gabe has definitely gotten older, too. Like, it's been years. I don't know how many years it's been, but it's been years that this has been going on. So, at least three, because I think it was two between season one and two, right? It's got to be at least three, because people look way older now. I wouldn't be surprised if it's like four or five or six. I don't even know. Like I said, I don't know. We may find out. And we'll bump into Clementine eventually, right? She has a group. I wonder if Kenny's in that group, or could have been in that group. I'll have to play through this again and check these things out. Man, like, I do these difference checks, where we see the different ways Telltale Games can play out, but, like, there's so many different ways this could play out, right? Boy. This is gonna be so good. And Telltale knows that they really want to make it so choices feel important with this more than ever. It's gonna be amazing. Is that like an ice pick? Are you okay?
You want a moment alone, Mari?
I'm praying I find a candy bar.
All right. What do we actually need?
A candy bar.
A candy bar.
Need, Mariana. Not want.
You heard the crowd. Please, God, let there be candy bars.
Amen.
All right. Well, let's start with some gas and move up from there.
Oh, wow. That's what happens when you don't hit the top of the head there. Oh, boy. Oh! Oh! My God. Wow, this one's tough. Okay, that probably will work.
Hey, where are you going?
Okay, that's cool. Have fun.
Oh, boy. Oh,
Jesus. It never ends with him.
The drama always gets these people killed.
I hate when they fight like that. I really hate it.
I'm sorry.
It's like all Gabe wants to do is argue. Doesn't matter what it's about.
Hey,
well, that makes two of us. But we're stuck with them, so at least you have your headphones.
Yeah, but the batteries have been dead for a couple of weeks.
Awkward.
I mostly wear them to fool you guys.
You sneaky little... That's smart. That's pretty smart.
Be nice to find some dinner.
In a junkyard.
You never know. These past 4 years, people have been hoarding all kinds of shit in all kinds of places.
I mean, it's Clementine's
oh,
nine.
And Mari,
I mean, 13.
If there's any trouble, you can find one of these cars.
Yeah?
Lock yourself in and don't come out. Not even once it's quiet. And wait as long as you can.
Okay.
Good girl.
She's not a dog. So she's 13. It's been 4 years. So it's been two extra years since season two, so they're going up by 2 years and 2 years, and we finally get to play. So yeah, this is what I was saying. I didn't think we were gonna play as Clementine, at least not exclusively. We might eventually play as her, but I think she's gonna be more of like a supporting character, which will be interesting. Let's go talk to you, huh? All right, wrap around this. This looks so good. Dang, like it still has like the comics feel.
Hey. Any luck, kiddo?
I need a pen.
Or what?
Or a pencil, just something to write with.
A pen? Why are you looking for that?
There's just something I really want. I really need to do. And I need a pen for it. Last night I was thinking about this stupid story my mom used to tell me all the time before bed. I used to hate it. But then I realized I don't remember the ending. It was this goofy ending she thought was so funny and I thought was so dumb. I want to write down everything I can remember about everything. Because if I forget and they're all gone, I'm kind of gone too. At least a little bit. I just think that might be kind of important. Maybe.
That's a great idea, Mariana.
Me and Mariana are buds right now, okay? Me and Mariana are buds. See, now, I wonder, like, if I would have told her to focus on supplies, could she have found some supplies? If I would have told her to focus on supplies, could she run into a zombie and get nibbled on? Who knows? Or maybe she's gonna get nibbled on because she's not looking for supplies. God, there's so many things that
just
could happen.
Just bits of old rubber and tires.
So, let's keep looking here, huh? Oh my god, there's two episodes we get to play, guys. Oh, it's gonna be great!
Most of the dashboard is torn out. Seats are gone. This thing's dead.
Yeah. I get to sit here and fanboy over and poke. What? Obviously I'm poking. I'm poking that. Poke. Poke it. Oh my god, poke the mattress. Poke.
Okay. Now I'm sorry I did that.
Why did you poke the blood, you ninny? Is there anything we can grab out of this?
That's gross.
That is gross. There's probably sex juice and zombie juice on there. Ew! All sorts of stuff to look at. Siphon? Oh yeah, we definitely gotta do that. Let's go talk to our lady friend over here.
You find anything?
I can't stop thinking about that herd. We get caught in it, and that's it. Peace, asshole. Can't charm your way out of that one. And we'd be gone in seconds.
But I'd still try to charm them. What would I have to lose?
It'd be pretty amusing, I'm sure. Until our eyeballs were ripped out of our skulls.
Yeah.
There's gonna be a last one, you know? A last tank of gas. Last piece of food. What if this place is empty? And the next. And the next.
We're not gonna let that happen. Okay?
Okay. I let it have its 5 minutes.
What?
I'm good.
Oh, that's gonna come up. I let it have its 5 minutes. Is that like the I'm guessing it's like, you let yourself have 5 minutes of fear or something like that, and then you just get it out of your system? It's gotta be what it is. I don't know, five minutes is kind of a long time, but I feel like we've seen something like that in Telltale Games before, or even in The Walking Dead in general. So, we got lots of stuff to at least try and siphon here. Lady's a little pessimistic over there, but we'll try to cheer her up a little bit. I don't know who's all gonna die. Oh god, I think Javier's gonna last a while, because he's one of the main characters. Will he die at the end? I don't know. Will Clementine die at the end? I don't know! Let's see if we can get something out of here. Can you not? Yeah. At least its hands fell off. Yeah. Couldn't have been too grabby if it tried. One thing that is interesting is that it's been 4 years, right? These zombies? You'd think, for the most part, seeing as how most of them probably died right away, you'd think that they're gonna start reaching the point where they aren't really that big of a threat anymore because they're too rotted. They can't move anymore. Like, their muscles are gonna deteriorate to the point where they actually can't move anymore.
Not much. But every bit helps.
Like, isn't that how this would end? I mean, granted, there's still gonna be new zombies being added every once in a while, but in comparison to the millions and millions and millions that likely died right away, it's gonna fizzle out.
Tires would fit the van.
The horde's gonna fizzle out. It's gonna be over. So, will we reach that point ever in The Walking Dead? I don't know. We're not even showing signs of that in the comics, I don't feel like.
Come
I guess,
to, Papa.
I guess they're rotting more, but it's not like they're talking about how it's all gonna be over soon. My gas tank disappeared. So,
barely anything. I'll need to find more.
I do think that's a legitimate point of the series. Like, it's gonna reach that point. Or, everyone we care about is gonna die. One of the two. So if this is 4 years later, man, I'm trying to, like, line this up with the comics, because I'm trying to think of how far we are in the comics. I don't want to spoil too much for you guys, but I don't know how far post-Negan is. Or, like, the main threat of Negan I don't know how far that is in the story. It's gotta be at least 3.
What's going on in there, buddy?
I'm in a bad mood, okay? I want it to go away, but it won't. I just wish we weren't always on the road. I like being with other people. Just, we're in that car so damn long. The AC hasn't worked in ages, and then it ate my last damn tape.
Let's let him talk.
I know. Get over it.
I didn't say
that. I just can't. I don't know. Maybe just leave me alone.
Okay. But if you want to talk later, I'm around.
Okay, side thought. One thing I noticed about Kate is that girl really is breathy. Like, I feel like I've already heard so many breath grunts out of that lady and we don't even know her yet. Maybe I should have looked at it first, huh? I didn't think about that. There are gonna be more zombies hanging out here.
Bingo.
We good? Alright, we got a decent bit of gas now, I guess. We couldn't try climbing up before. Maybe that would have interrupted our ability to get more gas. One thing you'll notice is that they never actually call these creatures we run into the walkers. They never call them zombies, right? And one interesting part about the Walking Dead's universe.
Nothing up there but garbage.
This is probably all this, like, useless stuff, right?
Tires, paint cans, old newspaper.
Yeah, this is junk.
All that's left in this junkyard is junk.
Yeah, I'm just wasting my time here, I think. I guess I'll take a look just in case.
Some sort of fuel tank.
Ooh. Okay. Okay. That might be interesting. We'll see. But like I was saying, one interesting part about the Walking Dead series is that the whole premise of what these creatures are, the walkers, the public, the living people, have never encountered a zombie before. Like, it's never been portrayed in the media. The whole idea of a zombie never even existed up until the walkers started showing up, which is why they don't call them zombies, right? So that's an important part. That's why
too risky to search up there. Doesn't look stable.
That's why so many people in the story here are like, whoa, what is this? What do I do? And they're experiencing it for the first time because zombies have never been portrayed in media.
Looks like there's more to see up here.
Which can kind of explain how some of them are so stupid. Climb or stay? It's a ladder, right? Like, my God.
Any luck?
Some. But not enough.
She probably would have climbed.
Gabe? Hey, Gabe. Let's go take a look over there.
Gabe, stay close to Javi. Got it?
Oh, all right.
I feel like I made a mistake. I could have stayed. If I stayed, would I just, like, not go yet? I don't know. I mean, we got tons of gas, right? We don't have that candy bar.
Look, there's one they never took to pieces.
Good catch.
It's right in front of your face. Right. We can open that. What else we got looking at around in here?
Yeah. Shit.
Hmm. Looks like it came from in there. Gabe, stay close.
What? No! No! I want to go back. Are you shitting me? No! I didn't want to. I was just checking out the area. I didn't want to leave the freaking untouched ambulance. I'm pissed.
Ransacked a long time ago.
We could have got gas. We could have maybe medical supplies. Nah. Screw it. I'm gonna hit the zombie and then completely never mind. I'm so mad right now. Back out. Oh, I'm peeking in, man. God! Oh.
Might be able to get in through the hatch.
Why is there a hatch?
Looks pretty run down.
I'm guessing I can't open it because he said I might be able to get in through the hatch, right? This is probably locked. Yeah.
Locked.
Yeah. I am so mad right now, though. Let me go back to the frickin'... Damn it! I feel like I missed out on something huge there. Like, I want to go back and replay it! That's not how these games are meant to be played. You're supposed to just deal with it. But man, oh god, that just doesn't even make sense. It's not what I would do. I wouldn't just keep going and forget about it. Whatever. We're done. What we really need to focus on is Javier not being done. Peekaboo! Why would you have a... Why would you...
Gabe, come check this out.
Why would you build a hatch into one of these things? Oh, wow.
Not the cleanest place.
Oh, no muertos, at least.
Muertos? So, like, dead ones?
Just be careful.
Okay. Whoa, guys. Did you notice that? Take a look at his back. See his compass? It kind of looks like a butthole for his backpack. Okay, did I see anything right here? No, I did not. I'm trying to be thorough. I know you guys appreciate that. Almost always. So I'm gonna take a look around here. I'll talk to him after I look at some- No, I'm gonna talk to him right away in case we lose the opportunity. Never mind. We're gonna talk right away.
Wow, this place is decked out. Oh, look at this place.
Interesting. So I don't actually get to talk to him, I just get to listen to him talk to himself. See, it's inside the drawer. Hey, batteries for... her headphones. I feel like that means she's gonna die. Now, there is one thing we're kinda waiting on here. If you recall the description of the episode 1, like right before we launched, it said... we run into another group and there's a horrible misunderstanding. So I'm waiting for that other group, and I'm guessing that's where Clementine's gonna be. Yum yum food?
What? Are you kidding me?
Lucky for you, they put enough preservatives in this stuff to last for centuries. There's enough food in here to keep us going for a long time.
You creepy kid, oh! Something's up here.
Oh, check it out. This is actual, honest-to-God, pudding!
Seriously?
And it's not just food. There's a mattress. There's blankets.
Someone else's mattress. Someone else's blankets.
Right.
We need to just take our gas and get on the road.
Doesn't feel safe.
This place does have a funny feeling about it. And if Muertos were to somehow surround us...
Great. Now I'm officially creeped out.
Sorry.
Come on, one night. We bunk down, eat a real meal.
No!
It would be nice not to sleep in the van for a change.
Please.
The herd is coming, if it's not here already. We should go and get ahead of it, before it's too late.
The fence is reinforced. We'll be fine.
No!
We found this. Why can't we just enjoy it?
Javi, can we?
No!
We're gonna get what we came for and get out of here.
Great. Another shitty cramp night in our shitty cramp van. Hooray.
Come on, let's at least grab the food.
Did you see how big that herd was, man? You dumb kids? Gabe's just emotional. Hey, I got batteries for you, girl. Save them for later. We get like a radio- oh god. I'm saving them, sorry. Now that you give me the option. Ugh.
Ugh. Hey, thanks for that. Backing me up and all. How does it feel to be the bad guy this time? It must be a new sensation for you.
We're in this together.
I don't know. Oh boy, sleeping in the van again? All I'll say is you definitely owe me one.
Yeah, well, you owe me like a dozen, so I'll just shave it off your tab.
Thanks.
Hey, Kate, can you come help us with this?
Hey, wait, but you...
This way you can make up for being the bad guy. Grab some gas. We need to head out soon.
That was a giant candy bar, by the way. So, I wonder who Kate is exactly.
What the fuck do you think you're doing with our gas?
Here's that,
speak up!
Here's that group.
Whoa, whoa, look, the gas is all there. You just keep it.
Yeah, I'm thinking it's a little too late for that.
Fine, I'll take it.
Ain't the loner type. I can tell. I know you got people.
They'll be back.
They're out scouting around. But they'll be back soon. They're not gonna be too happy if they see you pointing a piece at me.
Yeah, probably not. Then again, maybe they're already here, waiting to make an ambush.
Fan out, look for the others.
Lonnie, you're with me.
You guys seem a little aggressive, okay? Yeah, where are our weapons? We haven't seen weapons.
You assholes in there! I got your boy! You don't want him getting shot, you best come out there careful with your hands up.
Go on, you first. You get ambushed by your own people, that shit's gonna make my day. Open it real slowly.
Oh boy, talk dirty to me.
Had a real face time.
One whole cup of pudding.
You can't just take what you like. I don't roll over like that.
Look, I'll get you more food. Okay, I can replace everything, I
That's
swear.
That's the goddamn least you can do. Look, I get it, all right? You're starving. Who the fuck is it? At the end of your rope, thought you hit pay dirt. Honest mistake. But I got this sneaky fucking feeling.
Oh!
That you're full of shit.
What do you mean? Full of shit or what?
I ain't gonna let it be like the last time some assholes rolled on us. Keep an eye on this dickhead. I'm gonna grab some cuffs.
You got it. Just chill, okay? No need to make this any harder.
Chill. I'm chill.
Oh, please. You can take it easy with the tough guy routine there.
I didn't want to wince at you!
This doesn't have to go. The fuck was that noise? What you got hiding under there, boy?
A dog. It's got, it's allergic.
If you know something, you better spill it.
To bullshit. Grab crowbar.
You don't want me finding out for myself.
Go ahead and look.
Hey, if you're so curious, open it and find out. No, really. Go ahead. Do it.
He's gonna shoot.
Fuck it.
He's not shooting through there? Woohoo! Maybe I should have grabbed the crowbar.
Guys,
whoa! Whoa! Why did you guys move? Did you not hear me talking shit? Okay. You might want to stomp on him.
Holy shit.
What are you doing with the gun? Why did you throw the gun?
You have to pay for what you done here.
Wait, don't you?
What? You're gone! To make it so that you weren't
looking like you're gonna shoot him? Well, maybe you should've shot him!
Hey guys, this was the first part of The Walking Dead Season 3, Episode 1. We're finally back into the story. Next part, we finally meet some familiar faces, and I'm sure you know who they are, but I'm not gonna say it quite yet. So, hope you guys are excited for that. Make sure you click like down below to let me know. Leave a comment, tell me what you're thinking of the Season 3 so far, and I'll see you guys in the next video.